Houston, Texas has been a terrific home for the first residency of the 2021 Monster Energy AMA Supercross Championship, which is also an FIM World Championship. Hi folks, Leigh Diffey and the GOAT, Ricky Carmichael with you. Yeah, so we've had 1, 2, 3 events here in Houston at NRG Stadium in 7 days, and it's been super exciting, and certainly the way that it finished off tonight, because this is a flavour of the season to come, these residencies, as we're calling them, either 2-off or 3-off events at the one venue. Indianapolis is up next. But first of all, Ricky, what a night here tonight. Let's start with the 450s. Cooper Webb was victorious and kind of, I mean, he did get a great start. We'll see that in the highlights in a moment, but kind of came out of the blue.
Well, it did, and he is Ken Roczen's kryptonite. I go back to the battles that they have had a couple years ago, 2019, the closest finish in Monster Energy Supercross history in Arlington. Cooper Webb gets by Ken Roczen for the lead, last lap going up the finish line. Then go back last year to Oakland. He passes Ken for second. Eli Tomac won that race last corner, last lap. And then tonight wasn't the last corner this time. However,
close.
Yeah, it was about half a track to go. But, I mean, Cooper Webb just never gives up. However, he did have a little help because Dean Wilson just basically jammed Ken Roczen up. He should have gave way. He apologized on Instagram. It was really good of Dean Wilson to do that. He needed to do that, but I don't think the apology is good enough right
yeah.
now.
It was somewhat controversial, which you're about to see. Let's go to the highlights of this third round, and this is it. On the way home, Dean Wilson is the first bike in shot. Ken Roczen on the 94 trying to get by. Roczen said that he'd been screaming at him for several laps to get by. He loses his feet off the foot pegs, and then Cooper Webb goes for the attack straight across the line of Roczen. This is on the final lap of the race. The KTM rider back out in front, and Roczen could not respond. Cooper Webb did everything he could, Ricky, just to hang on.
Well, he did. He was trying to ride defensive. He knew Ken was going to give him the business if he could get close enough. And I thought Ken was going to go for it right here, but he just couldn't. I mean, Cooper Webb is just too intuitive of a rider. He knew and could sense what Kenny was going to do.
Look at that. Third different winner in as many races here in Houston. He was pumped. This is how annoyed Roczen was with Dean Wilson.
Yeah, super displeased and has every right to be.
So, a different podium again with Cooper Webb, Ken Roczen, and Adam Ciancerillo getting his first podium since San Diego last year. And there are the points. So Roczen, I mean, it's bittersweet, right? He didn't win. He was frustrated, but he does get the points lead.
Yeah, I mean, big picture, Lee, he's right where he needs to be. Yes, would he like to win? But he's back up there. And I'm going to say it again. It's like musical chairs. It really is. We had three different winners, six different guys the first two rounds on the podium. And I expect the same thing when we turn up in Indy next Saturday night.
Well, that's a great point. There have been 8, because Roczen's the only one to double up. There have been 8 different riders from a potential 9 podium spots. It's been an incredible start to this year. We're going to welcome in Will Christien, but to Daniel Blair first. Daniel, what did you make of the 450 main?
It was awesome. I mean, what a fight and what a battle, and the games that were being played with the lap traffic, and Cooper Webb at one point got caught up in it, lost ground. I thought maybe that would have been it, and he's just so tough in the last few minutes. So to charge back and make that move in the last lap, I mean, we kind of saw it coming when they got close. He's got Ken's number in those one-on-ones. But I want to focus on Adam Ciancerillo. That's his first podium of the year. Remember, he only had 2 last year as a rookie, and I think that's a win for him. Look, he's chasing the win, you know, the top of the podium. But right now in this championship, as wild as things are, a podium is like a win. He gets 21 points. That's a lot of points. And I'm just looking at the big picture. He's only 9 down in the championship after 3 races. And for Ciancerillo to just kind of back it off, ride alone, stay in third when things were, you know, the leaders were getting away, he didn't overreact, that's a win. For a rider who has some issues and goes down, tries a little too hard, I am super happy with the way he approached this race. The track was tough. He mellowed out halfway through. Stable ride, solid day, quiet day, 3rd place. He needs 3 or 4 more of those, I think, just to build and stack. and then take your shot at a win. So in my opinion, although it's a third, it's a big win for Adam Cincirillo tonight.
Yeah, that's a great point, because he wasn't close as far as time, like distance behind the eventual winner, Cooper Webb, but he was quite satisfied with it.
Well, yeah, like to Daniel's point, what he said, he was happy. He says he didn't make any mistakes, and I am with Daniel on that. He has got to string in 3 or 4 or 5 more rides, but he's in great position.
Will, how about for you? What got your attention on the 450 main?
I just want to pick up quickly before we move on, Adam Cincirillo, and the conversation that you guys were having there, because I found it interesting what the team, what the Monster Energy Kawasaki team had told me earlier on in the day, because, you know, it's easy to think if we look back to Tuesday that that mistake that we saw Adam go down in the sand there, that was maybe a little typical of him. But the team considered it a blip on the radar, as they put it. They said it's not indicative of how he's been. It's definitely doesn't represent how his off-season's been, or even how he was through the summer there when we saw him compete in the Pro Motocross season two. They said he's grown so much. So I just found that interesting that the team, to them, this is what they were expecting from him. So to Daniel's point there, you can only expect it to grow from here. And then my mind goes to Ken Roczen there. We saw he's got the red plate now. He is in the lead. But wow, what a way to do it. He just seems to have been on the wrong end of things. He's spoken very overtly about how he's worked on his nutrition physically, but also worked mentally on stuff. He's had a coach, a sports psychology expert there who's been working with him. And he kind of alluded to it on the podium, didn't he? He said, you know, I've been working on this. I'm very frustrated. I want to punch a wall, but I've been working on this. He's going to have to dig deep yet again here for 2 rounds in a row. And this really is putting to test everything, all that new attitude that he's trying to put in place. Not that we ever saw him as a particularly fiery rider, but clearly he feels like he's found something else as far as the psyche goes. And it's going to get put to test again. But I wonder if that really, guys, is going to be to his strength. Because if he can get through this and get through this and still sit at the top of the points lead, really, maybe it's a mark of what's to come for the rest of the season.
And he's in the same position as he was at this same stage last year. That's at the top the points. All right, let's shift gears. Let's go to the 250 East main event tonight. And in same style as the 450s, 3 races, 3 different winners. Same for the 250s with Colt Nichols bringing up his first victory in some 2 years. It was a really gutsy performance. I think it was a very clever performance, don't you?
Yeah, I like that word, clever performance. Oh, like a veteran of the 450 class. I mean, he was just sitting there lurking on his teammate, never lost his wheel behind Christian Craig, made a pass. Christian Craig passes him back. Then he gets back by his teammate on that on-off section in the back. And really, he never wavered, never rode over his head. And I was really, really inspired by his ride that he put in here tonight.
All right, let's take a look at the highlights, because you'll see it for yourselves. It was really, it was an interesting one for sure. The right-handed turn one, and it's 2 blue and white Monster Energy Star Racing Yamahas of points leader Christian Craig and Colt Nichols 1-2. The youngster, Max Volan, got a terrific start on the KTM, but here are the teammates duking it out, and this is where Colt Nichols finally got into the lead, but it was short-lived, Ricky.
Yeah, it was short-lived, because Christian Craig gets back by Colt Nichols through the whoops right here. There's a lapper. He splits the gap and goes up the inside. I mean, he had led the whole race. He didn't want to go down like that. And I wasn't quite sure if Colt Nichols was going to be able to get by, but he did. He goes up the inside right there, and the lappers were really, really bad tonight. It was able to allow Colt Nichols to get by, and he rides it on into the sunset.
First win since Anaheim 1, 2019, and a much-needed one, and a much-needed psychological boost as far as the intra-team battle with Christian Craig. So we're all square at the top, tied, heading to Indy.
Look at that. I mean, only 6 points back. Jet Lawrence out of the lead position for the championship. And our man Joe Shimoda just quietly putting those top fives in there.
And Michael Moseman aboard the GasGas in the top five.
Unfortunately, you look at this points, we did lose 2 powerhouse guys, RJ Hampshire, Austin Faulkner. Ironically, those were the 2 guys that had a run in when we were here on Tuesday. So I just go back to Austin Faulkner. Another year that he has had an injury that's going to take him out of championship contention.
Yeah.
And, just, you know, these years pass you by, and there's seasons you can't get back.
He needs to get healthy, that's for sure, first and foremost. Will, I want to start with you on your thoughts of the 250 East main tonight.
Well, Lee, you and and Ricky have mentioned a couple of times that Colt Nichols have kind of come into the season somewhat under the radar. And I find that interesting because his results kind of tell a bit of a different tale, don't they? When we look at them, he went third in the first round, a second in the second round, and we all thought, wow, that's fantastic, here comes Colt. Well, talking to him earlier, he considered that he actually wasn't riding that well. He said, I'm not that comfortable, and I can do better than that, which surprised me. It took me back. So they made some bike changes. They made some adjustments to get that comfort. And then what do we see today? A first. So third, second, first. So it just tells me, Colt, where he was in his head, what he thought his expectations of himself were, and where he put the benchmark was probably far higher than any of us had even realized. And I said to him, you know, there's a lot of attention on you now. All eyeballs are on you now. How do you feel about that? And he said, I kind of like it. You know, it feels good. I haven't been in this position before. So, Daniel, I think he's just enjoying it at this point.
Well, he should be. He's got the red plate now. He'll be sharing it with his teammate, Christian Craig. And again, to your point, he's just been kind of creeping up on that top spot. And tonight he gets it. I love the word clever. It was a very, very clever ride. He used the lap traffic to his advantage. So great ride for Colt. You know what stands out for me is Jet Lawrence. Look, he had a huge crash in practice and qualifying. We were all worried, like, is he going to be okay? And the bike hit his leg really bad. He gets up limping. And, you know, he walks out for the heat race, and I could tell he was limping, but he was trying to walk normal. And then the podium interview, he talked about how he didn't ride well, but he wasn't wanting to blame the leg. And I appreciate that from him. He's trying to not draw attention to it. He's just, you know, I'm tough, I'm fine. But I know that affected him. You could tell by the way he rode today. After the crash, the edge was gone. That fire that he had been riding with was gone, and he just salvaged. So I'm not sure what he's going to say after all this, but I know he was feeling that. I could tell by the way he was walking to the gate that something was bothering him. I respect the fact that he's trying to be tough, but something was bothering him, and it took the edge off. So I want to see what he does when we get to Indy after he gets some time to heal up, because he's obviously not injured. He's just hurt. And you can recover from that maybe with a week or two of some therapy, or a day or two of some therapy. So when we get to Indy, will Jet be the Jet we saw before the crash, or will he still be lingering and kind of dealing with what he dealt with tonight?
Good points. Thanks for your work tonight, guys, both Will and Daniel. So only three races into this, but have we already whittled down to the championship three, meaning the two-star Yamaha guys in Christian Craig, Colt Nichols, and then HRC Honda's Jet Lawrence? Are they the championship three?
I sure think it has been narrowed down, especially with RJ Hampshire going out and Austin Fortner going out. So we're going to keep an eye on those three guys. I do think you're going to see perhaps guys like Joe Shimoda get in there, Michael Moseman get in there. Also, will the rookie Max Bolan get in there? He's been very impressive These first three rounds. So it's anybody's game, and it's funny. I was looking up at that 250 podium tonight, and the three guys that were up on that podium were the three winners.
Yeah. It's been a terrific start to the 2021 season. We are looking forward to the next event, which is also a residency with three races. Saturday, Tuesday, Saturday at the racing capital of the world, Indianapolis, Indiana. That is it just in a week's time, Saturday, January 30. We'll see if this trend of a different winner at a different round continues. It has been quite the way to start the year, and we say thank you, Houston. See you in Indy.
Hi, I'm Will Christien, and thank you all so much for watching. I'm here to remind you to hit subscribe for all the latest Supercross news and highlights. And of course, don't forget to sign up for Peacock Premium. That is now the new home for streaming for all live Supercross events all season long.